Welcome back. With the never-ending to-do list during the holidays, the last thing you want to stress about, right, is what you're going to be packing and wearing if you're traveling during Thanksgiving. I'm joined this morning by our stylist, Raquel Greer-Gordian. She's going to give us a few tips on how to travel and then enjoy Thanksgiving like a pro. And this is pretty big because a lot of people aren't originally from Texas nowadays. We're going to be doing some traveling during the holiday season, so you've kind of already got the traveling outfit on lock. Talk to me this morning about what you're wearing.
Absolutely. So this is kind of the outfit that you could wear for the plane. Now, you know, a lot of times, you know, when we think comfortable and you want to be comfortable on the airplane, we think, you know, it's just stuff that you would throw on. It doesn't necessarily have to be cute, but you can have both of those things in one outfit. So for this look, I have on my leggings.
I'm dying for these leggings. I didn't tell you this before, but what are these? These are fabulous.
Yeah, well, metallic is one of the biggest trends right now, and it's such a fun way to kind of like brighten up, energize your airplane look, and they're just as comfortable as regular leggings.
And you're going to be able to chat to people because they're going to be complimenting you along the way. If you need some friends during the travel season, this
Absolutely.
Is the way to get them.
Yeah, and so, you know, in addition to that, I've added just a simple sweater. Now, if you're going to do, you know, a graphic print legging, just something simple too. As you can see with the bronze leggings, this sweater kind of plays into that color a little bit. And then on top, I've added my moto vest. Now, moto vests, or just vests in general, are a great thing to kind of throw on if you're moving between climates.
Yes.
You know, because it doesn't feel too much if you're, you know, coming from somewhere warmer, going to somewhere cold, and then once you arrive at somewhere cold, you've got a little bit, you know, you've got a little extra
and
layer.
And I find no matter where I'm going, what time of the year it is, airplanes are always cold.
Mm-hmm.
So it doesn't even matter if you're going to Maui over Thanksgiving, do you know what I mean? You're probably still going to need a layer
Absolutely,
like this.
Absolutely, yeah. And then in addition, I have the scarf too. So this, you know, if you have, you know, a tote, a carry-on, you can throw this in. And then if the airplane is really cold, you pull it out. It's comfy, cozy if you want to sleep on the airplane, and it's just a fun addition.
You know what? You're wearing some really chunky jewelry, and I'm wondering if that was a conscious thought as well about what you're going to be wearing on the airplane.
Absolutely. So I tend to wear a lot of jewelry on the airplane because, again, it can be comfortable, but you really want to style it up. And this necklace is, it's actually made from coconuts. So it's, yeah, so it's pretty delicate. So my more delicate pieces, too, I don't like to put in my bag because for fear of them breaking.
Smart.
So I throw this on, and then, you know, I love hoops, so I always got to have those on as well.
Well, I always think of big jewelry when I'm traveling just because it's the easiest thing to find again if you have to take it off and put it, like, you know, through the security check. Because
Absolutely.
Those hoops are going to be real easy to find
yes.
instead of, like, tiny
Absolutely.
Little studs. So some thick jewels are a good idea. And then, of course, you have these boots, and we're all about the animal print right now.
Yes. And so, yeah. And so on the airplane, again, you know, if you pick the right kind of stacked heel, block heel, it can be just as comfortable as, you know, a sneaker on the airplane, and then the snakeskin kind of gives it that little bit of you know, personality and style,
and keeps your toes warm as well. And so then you wanted to talk about my outfit. You've styled me specifically for today. I am doing the Eaton.
Yes.
This is for Thanksgiving.
Absolutely. Yeah. So we've taken a simple, super simple black dress. Now the key to this dress is it's kind of A-frame.
And
it's
I can
stretchy.
Do a lot of consumption of food in this dress.
Which is so key. Yeah. But then you really, you know, I love to dress up for Thanksgiving. So where it is a little bit more casual, we've really put it into that kind of dressy casual category by adding this necklace. So we've got kind of all the gold beads in there. We've got the fringe, which is so fun and festive. And then to play into those gold beads, we've also added this little mustard kind of shawl sweater on top. And then, of course, too, on bottom, we've also dressed it up a little bit with your leopard heels. And then also we've added that rose gold, those gold details to kind of play back into the necklace and then play into the warmth of the sweater too.
Yeah, I do think it brings it up a couple of notches because we have a more dressed down version that you could do with this exact same shawl, wear it with a plaid or something like that. But I also love that it's very autumnal, all these colors. So I'm excited
yes.
about that. And then if we're done eating, maybe we had an energy drink and we're booting up for Black Friday. You've got Caitlin, our intern, styled beautifully for this.
Yeah, absolutely. So, you know, you're still feeling kind of, you had a big meal, obviously, the day before.
As we did, yes.
So you want to be comfortable. You want to be relaxed. So what I've done with her is kind of put her in this boyfriend denim. So rather than having your super structured skinnies, this gives you a little bit of room to kind of relax in. And then for the top, you know, she's got a little bit of stretch to it. So it's also comfortable.
Very thoughtful, Raquel.
And then the color is one of the biggest colors right now. So the dusty rose. And then with with the dusty rose, I've played into kind of that burgundy heel. Now, when you're wearing these boyfriend jeans, you need a little bit of lift.
Okay.
So very much like the shoe that I'm wearing, she kind of has that block heel, that stacked heel, where you get a little bit more comfort. You know, if she's walking around doing Black Friday shopping, they're the kind of heels that you could really be in, you know, all day.
Okay, so boyfriend jeans means you need to elevate the shoe. I did not know that. And then she's got this lovely light coat on top, should you be running in and out of the mall, et cetera?
Mm-hmm, absolutely, yeah. The utility jacket is perfect because, again, it's got that relaxed feel like the jeans do, so it really fits the style of the whole look and just kind of that she is going to be running around and
love it.
Hanging out all day.
Okay, Raquel, and in 12 seconds or less, explain to us quickly, if someone's maybe just tuning in for the first time, what you do.
Yeah, absolutely. So I help women of Austin understand how to get creative with their wardrobes, work with 100% of their wardrobes, and really create looks that make them feel both powerful and beautiful every day.
And she does use everything that's actually already in your closet, so you don't have to go running for, you know, to do some Black Friday shopping in order to make it work. Thank you so much. Great,
of course,
as always. To learn more about Raquel's styling and shopping services, check out GreerImageConsulting.com. You can also get tips and inspiration from her on Instagram. It's at Raquel Greer Gordian.